too late to be scared now.
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, it's your homie, Futuristic Mike, and I'm back with another Power Book 2 Ghost video if you're new. Now, this is going to be the recap for the Power Book 2 Ghost official Season 2 trailer. If you're a fan of Power, hit the like on this video. If you're new to my channel and this is the first time you're finding me, subscribe and turn on those post notifications so when I post videos on Power Book 2 Ghost, you get them. Now, this trailer looks interesting. I think it looks better than the Season 1 trailer for Power Book 2 Ghost. This season is going to be insane, man. You know, Season 1 was just pretty much the continuation of Power Season 6, and it was the buildup of what's going to come for this season. And I can't wait, because this season is definitely going to be, you know, way more exciting than Season 1 was. It's going to have more action, more drama, more everything. You know, Tariq, he's going to be trying to hide what he did to Jabari, and I think Kerry is going to find out. I don't know, but when this trailer first starts, you know, it shows what happened last season, where Tariq was in the park with Kane. You know, Kane had the gun on Tariq, then he gave it to Tariq, and Tariq took care of Jabari Reynolds. And then it shows him waking up, so he must be dreaming about it or whatever, having nightmares. Then we see the cops, paramedics and everything, and we see Tariq standing there. You know, they found out that Jabari is dead. Then we see Monet and she doesn't look happy. This might be when she finds out what Tariq did to Jabari. Then we see Kerry identifying his body. You know, she's looking at him. Then it shows her, you know, she's crying and stuff. She's really upset. We know she had a history with Jabari. Even though those two weren't together at the time Jabari got killed, she still cared about him. Then we see Tariq, and he's looking at his phone, and it says, "Beloved Stansfield professor found murdered off campus." So Tariq is going to have to do whatever he can to try to hide his life, to make sure people don't dig into, you know, what he's doing and stuff, because best believe they're going to be investigating everybody that was in Jabari's class. And it looks like Brayden is making a face like he just found out. You know, we see Kerry and she's talking to a detective or whatever, and then it shows everybody in class because they're going to be looking at everybody in that class. And we see your girl Sullivan, she's going to be back for a regular role. You know, she's a series regular this season, and we see everybody going into class. We see Tariq talking to Kane, and Kane is saying, "Look, I'm not going down for this." Tariq is basically telling him that, you know, he got some and stuff. Then we see Tariq going into the police station, and we know Tariq, you know, he's not going to go down for it. They just probably got questions for him. Then, you know, Sax, they show him, and then he's talking to Davis, and he's saying, you know, your client might have gotten wrapped up in another murder. And, you know, Method Man, he's just like, okay, cha-ching. That's all he sees is that money. We see Drew walking down the street, and you know, I think they're gonna make Drew step it up this season, but it looks like somebody's watching Drew or the Tejada family. And we see Monet saying to Tariq, "Sure, no one be looking in your direction for this." We see Diana at the table too. And then next we see Kane talking to the new plug, Mecca, and they're in some warehouse with some cars and stuff. Looks like Mecca is gonna have Kane handle something. We see some dude, Kane's walking up to him, looks like he's getting ready to fight him. Then we hear Monet saying, "Now you know what happens if you lying, right?" And Tariq says, "I do." And then we see Kane fighting somebody, and I don't know who it is, but I do remember when the teaser first came out that, you know, people were guessing on who Kane might be fighting and stuff, but I don't know who that might be. We see Rashad Tate, he's gonna be a series regular. Tariq is going up to him saying, "I could use some help from someone of your stature." So, you know, Rashad Tate is probably going to be helping Tariq with something. I'm not sure what. And then we see, you know, somebody is taking some money out of this box. We see Tariq, and then Diana's on the phone saying, "We got some more product coming soon." We see Tariq in the room with Effie, and we see Brayden. His face looks messed up. There's blood on his face or something. I don't know what happened. And, you know, Effie, she's going to be stepping it up this season as well. We see Kane with a whole bunch of bricks, and he's in front of Mecca. Wherever they're at, they're doing some business. Then we see Tariq in class saying we all got to play the hand we dealt. We see Lorenzo, he's still in jail, but we know he's probably going to be getting out in this season. I remember they were filming a scene with Lorenzo a while back with him in the car or whatever. I remember I seen that on Instagram. But then we see Davis talking to his brother, Redman, in jail. And I hope Redman gets out. If he doesn't, maybe he'll get out in season 3. But we see Kane with a whole bunch of bags and stuff. They all got to deal with the consequences in this season. For real, the consequences are coming. Then we see Tariq and Brayden with the bags. So they're getting some product from the Tejadas. And we see Rashad Tate, you know, he has on his suit. He's up to something. We see Lauren, and she's saying there's just certain boundaries you don't cross. Then we see, you know, somebody robbing a jewelry store. And this right here reminds me of Power. I don't remember exactly what episode it was, but I remember one episode, Kanan was with Dirk and some other people robbing a jewelry store for Jukebox. If you guys remember, I think it was season 4. But this reminds me of the old classic Power right here. You know, they're throwing a bag, probably saying put the jewelry in the bag. We see light-skinned Keisha is back. Thank God, I'm glad they're bringing her back. We see Tariq talking to Lauren, and he says, what if it was to protect yourself? Because she's saying there's just certain boundaries you don't cross. He's asking, what if it's to protect yourself? And we see Tariq with a gun. He's going to need to keep that at all times because things are getting dangerous. Then we see Method Man, and he's telling somebody don't talk to anyone. We see Zeke is getting questioned by the police. I don't know if he's going to crack or not. We see Drew walking in, and Kane is back in the family, it looks like. Monet is saying, I do whatever I need to do to make sure this family is straight. And we see her shooting somebody. Of course, man, she always has somebody on the ground shooting them. But, you know, she's talking to Kane, it looks like, when she's saying, I do whatever I need to do to make sure this family is straight and this business doesn't fall. We see Kane partying and shit. We see Carrie crying. You know, she's super upset. We see Drew punching some dude or whatever. Drew, he's definitely stepping it up. We see Yasmin and somebody saying she's going to a good home. And Tariq says, but I'm her family. So maybe Tariq just wants to take her and take care of her. And we see Rashad Tate. He's saying, I need to speak with you. Might be talking to Tariq because we see Tariq turn around. It looks like he's in front of Rashad Tate, or maybe he's trying to talk to Carrie. I don't know. But we see Tariq getting ready to sleep with Lauren. So he's finally going to clap those cheeks. Maybe. I don't know. Last time they tried to do something, it didn't work out because Tariq had blood on his shirt. We see Tariq. He's into some shit. Then we see him kissing Diana. So, of course, you know, he's going to be into all the girls again this season. Then we see Effie opening the door for somebody. I don't know who it is. Probably Diana. Then we see Sullivan on top of Sax. I bet that's Sax. She's smashing Sax again. Then we see Brayden saying, give me Tariq. You know, he wants to call Tariq on the Bluetooth. Then we see Kane coming out of this door, and he has a gun, and he's shooting at somebody. Then we see in a warehouse, some dudes are shooting back and forth, and it's just going to get crazy. There's an all-out war. We see Diana and Effie are arguing, and we see Tariq is in the middle. I don't know what it's about. I don't know if it's about product or if it's about Tariq. Maybe it's just about, you know, them wanting Tariq. I guess Tariq is a player. But who do you guys think would win between Diana and Effie in a fight? Comment down below. I'm interested to know what you guys would think. But we see Zeke getting ready to sleep with Carrie, and these two can just go. I don't want to see these two together anymore, in my opinion. Screw that, man. I don't want to see these two together at all. Then we see Kane and Mecca shooting. You know, Kane has his little gun, and Mecca has a shotgun or whatever. Then we see Davis talking on the news. So I don't know what's going on here. Then we see your boy, Kanan Stark. Yes, it's your boy Kanan Stark. He will be back as a flashback or a ghost or whatever. And he's saying, you're supposed to be on your man shit, right? And he's just saying to Tariq, it's too late to be scared now. So he's basically telling Tariq that, you know, he's a man now and he has to do what he has to do. There's no more looking back and there's no being scared. But I'm happy we're going to see 50 Cent on the show again as Kanan. That shit right there is dope. They need to bring Amari Hardwick back as Ghost and do this as well, where you see a ghost or whatever, where, you know, Tariq is talking to his dad. That shit would be dope. But what did you guys think of the trailer? I thought it was dope. I cannot wait until season 2. It looks fire as hell. I'm ready, man. For November 21st, I'm too ready. Comment your theories and everything down below, your thoughts and everything else. Keep supporting your boy, and I'll be continuing to bring y'all Power Book 2 Ghost content in the future. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and smash that notification bell so you can never miss a video. If you guys want to donate to the channel, I got links below to the PayPal and Cash App accounts. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me get out of here, y'all. It's your boy, Futuristic Mike, and I'll talk to you on the next one. I'm out. Peace.